Speaking of which, we'll go right into this next story. I thought this was interesting. It's another education story, and this one is with a little bit of a twist. Instead of the education establishment begging for more money, this story actually details the salaries of the two heads of the top teachers' unions. Randy Weingartner, who runs the American Federation of Teachers, her pay jumped to $407,000 between 2010 and 2011. If you factor in paid expenses and stipends, then she ends up with almost $500,000, $493,000, basically $494,000. Not to be outdone by too much, Dennis Van Rokel from the National Education Association, he received a raise to $362,000. Again, adding in paid expenses and stipends, that brings him to $460,000. Now, their salaries put them in the top 1% of earners in the country. Not too bad if it weren't for the problem of the average teacher salary is $44,000 a year. Nearly 600 staffers there at these two unions have six-figure salaries. That's at both unions. To try and blunt the criticism, Weingarten said, quote, "Last year, I and the other two American Federation of Teachers officers, as well as all management, took a voluntary pay freeze. We did so because no one knows better than we do the economic distress our members are experiencing." Yeah, you know, you could pay me almost $500,000 and freeze my pay right there, too. Notice there was no talk about a pay cut, just a pay freeze. Would you take a pay freeze at a $500,000 there, Tori?
Sure, yeah.
Yeah.
Just freeze me right on to $500,000.
Yeah, I think that's so hilarious when people are saying that. Yeah, freeze my pay at a $500,000. That's really going to crimp my style there.
Now, I'm sure there was much griping.
Yeah, exactly. And,
no, you can't do that.
I've got to live on this.
Yeah.
That's what, a little under $10,000 a week.
How can I live on $10,000 a week?
I don't know.
I've got things.
I've got stuff.
I need more stuff.
And yes, more stuff. One of the things I find so funny is when these people advocate for higher and higher taxes to fund education, then turn right around and rip it off, and then get upset when we call them on it. But let someone express some reservations about how much we spend on education here in America and how little we get in return compared to other countries. They act like the self-righteous, arrogant people they really are. How dare you ask the Almighty why you must pay so much in taxes? This is for the children, and no cost is too great when it comes to them. So, excuse me, don't you think you're getting paid a little too much? Of course, they'll tell you, that's none of your concern. Get back to working and pay your taxes. It is time for us to make it our concern. This is for you teachers out there that are in these unions. Make these people justify their requests for more money with hard evidence. These guys are taking tons of money, and as I stated, the average teacher salary is $44,000 a year. I find it hard to believe that that's over 10 times what an average teacher makes, that they're really earning their money up there in this union. What they're basically doing is hamstringing our educational system.